Hello and welcome. Tonight we complete 300 episodes of Truth versus Hype. And I wish our focus tonight could have been on a subject less dark. But then we are in dark times. In Bulandshahr, a double atrocity seems to be unfolding. First, a mob whipped into a frenzy by the discovery of cow carcasses that goes on a rampage and that culminates with the murder of a police officer, all of it caught on camera. But then a second atrocity. The chief minister, no less, seems to be deflecting attention away from the crime and to refocus attention on cow slaughter. A statement issued at the end of the first meeting he held on Bulandshahr was silent on the murder of the police inspector, instead focusing almost solely on combating cow slaughter. And if this wasn't enough, the chief minister now says that what occurred in Bulandshahr is an accident, not lynching. Now, this kind of political response to the violence is not surprising. The men accused of inciting the mobs are linked to the same ideological parivar that rules UP. One of the accused is from the Bajrang Dal, another accused is from the VHP, a third is from the BJP. And it seems to have become imperative to deflect blame away from them. In this, the chief minister seems to be going against the findings of his own police force. NDTV has learnt that in a report prepared by a senior police official on Bulandshahr, it's been found that the Bajrang Dal activists and his supporters used the discovery of the cow slaughter to conspire to deliberately escalate the violence. And yet, of the 27 men named in the FIR for the mob violence, the police have arrested only 8. But of the 5 named for cow slaughter, the police have arrested 4, all of them Muslim men. NDTV's Shruti Menon chased down each of those 4 arrests to find more questions than answers.
This is the brother of Safruddin, one of those arrested on charges of cow slaughter, picked up from Nayabas village, 4 kilometers away from the spot of the violence. His brother says Safruddin, a fabric trader, was at the ijtima, or congregation of Muslims, when the incident occurred, and has proof to back his claim. Hussain says that his brother has been implicated by Yogesh Raj, the Bajrang Dal leader, because of history between them.
Sarfuddin ka jo naam aa raha hai wo Yogesh Raj ne liya hai. Yogesh Raj usse Sarfuddin se dushmani manta hai kyunki Sarfuddin jo hai masjid ka jo adhyaksh hai wo mic bhi band ho gaya jab se Yogi sarkar aayi hai hamare yahan ki jo masjid hai jiske wo adhyaksh bane hue hain uska mic band kara diya inhone jaise wo hinduwadi hai hum bhi muslimwadi hai apne haq ke liye to hum bhi ladenge na usko wo bura lagta tha.
A stone's throw away from Sarfuddin is the house of another accused, 26-year-old Sajid Ali. Shabir, his uncle, who is the only member of that family left in that village, says that Sajid left the village 12 years ago.
वो यहाँ 12 साल से गए हुए हैं, 12 या 11 साल हो गए, अंदाज़ में.
कहाँ गए हैं?
वो फरीदाबाद रहते हैं, बड़खल में. उनके वहाँ के सबके आधार कार्ड वगैरह सब कुछ वहीं के उनकी आईडी हैं.
आखिरी बार कब आए थे वो यहाँ?
आखिरी बार वो आए थे बकराईद से पहले 20 दिन 25 दिन पहले हमारी मम्मी खत्म हुई थी शायद 10 सितंबर की बात है ये.
Two other men, Banne Khan, a wage laborer, and Asif, a watch repairman, neither of their names feature in the FIR. Banne Khan lives in Ahmedgarh, nearly 50 kilometers from Bulandshahr. Some say Banne may have never even been to Siana, the spot of the incident.
Banne अपने घर पर ही सो रहे थे. मजदूर आदमी चिनाई का काम करते हैं, चिनाई करके आए थे, अपने खाना वाना खा के घर पे सो गए. रात को पुलिस आई, पुलिस इन्हें घर से उठा के ले गई, बोली कि कुछ थाने चलो, पूछताछ करनी है. जाता सियाना को तो कोई इधर से रूट भी नहीं है, ना ही बन्ने खां की कोई रिश्तेदारी है, इधर को कभी जाते भी नहीं है, हो सकता बन्ने खां ने सियाना देखा भी नहीं हो.
आसिफ, अ वॉच रिपेयरमैन, मूव्ड टू मुंबई विद हिज वाइफ नियरली 4 इयर्स अगो अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज फैमिली. ही वाज इन बुलंदशहर फॉर द इज्तिमा एंड पिक्ड अप फ्रॉम हिज हाउस.
काफी दिनों से बाहर ही रहता है,
कहाँ रहते हैं?
मुंबई।
कितने टाइम से?
4 साल हो गए उसकी शादी को। कभी उसका गांव है, उसका घर है, तो कभी कभी आ भी जाता है।
जब ये हुआ था तब वो कहाँ पे थे?
इस्ता मामा से दुआ के बाद घर पे आया और रात को सोया बस।
We repeatedly asked the police on what grounds these men had been arrested. Senior police officials told us off the record that Sarfuddin and Sajid had been arrested because their names were in the FIR. However, they didn't clarify why Banne Khan and Asif were arrested. With camera person Xavier Thomas, Shruti Menon from Bulandshahr for NDTV.
It gets worse. It's not just the minority community. It appears that the murdered police officer too is being scapegoated. Soon after Inspector Subodh's murder, it came to light that local Hindutva groups had complained to the Bulandshahr BJP MP, blaming the inspector for anti-Hindu actions. One of the accused in the case, who's from the BJP, even accused the inspector of corruption in a video this accused made while he was in hiding.
सुबोध कुमार सिंह की मौजूदगी में हुआ है और मैं पूरे दावे के साथ कह सकता हूं कि शाने का बच्चा बच्चा जानता है कि सुबोध कुमार सिंह कितने ज्यादा करप्ट और कैसे इंसान थे, जिन्होंने मुस्लिम समुदाय के लोगों से यारी करके हमारी माताओं पर प्रहार करवाया है। बिल्कुल भी बर्दाश्त नहीं किया जाएगा। मुझे सरकार जांच कर ले, मुझे योगी सरकार पे, उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार पे, प्रदेश सरकार पे पूर्ण रूप से भरोसा है कि ये सरकार, चाहे मैं दोषी हूं तो मुझे सूली पर लटका दिया जाए।
Just today, yet another police official in Bulandshahr, seen to have been tough on the mob, has been transferred, apparently at the behest of the local BJP MLA. For this, the MLA was fed laddus by his supporters.
Bharat Mata Ki! Deshbandhu Mahasangh!
Jindabad!
Devinder Lodhi!
Jindabad!
No words, really. Well, joining us tonight on the debate, we have with us IP Singh, leader of the BJP from Lucknow. Vrinda Grover, senior advocate, is also on the show with us. Dr. Vikram Singh, former DG Police of Uttar Pradesh, is on the show with us as well. And here in the studio, we have Rahul Kaushik, member of the RSS. IP Singh Saab, ab kya kahein? जो हम देख रहे हैं उत्तर प्रदेश में, हम समझ नहीं पा रहे हैं कि आपकी जो सरकार है वो किसके पक्ष में है। वो जो अपराधियों के पक्ष में है जिसने एक पुलिस अफसर की हत्या कर दी, या वो कानून के पक्ष में है?
देखिए,
चीफ मिनिस्टर कह रहे हैं कि ये पूरी घटना एक एक्सीडेंट थी। आप मानते हैं ये घटना एक एक्सीडेंट थी?
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, पूजनीय योगी जी ने बहुत साफ तौर से कहा कि यह दुर्घटना थी। आप समझिए कि पूजनीय योगी जी की छवि को तार तार करने की किस तरह से हम उनकी सरकार के खिलाफ साजिश रची गई। जहां यह घटना घटी उससे ठीक 40 किलोमीटर दूर 50 लाख मुसलमान इत्तेजमा में इकट्ठा होता है और एक थप्पड़ भी मार पड़ती है एक दूसरे के ऊपर, उसके बाद भी जो संगम होता है उनका, ये कानून व्यवस्था है। लेकिन जो साजिश रचने वाले लोग हैं उसे नाकामयाब करने का काम हमारी सरकार ने किया है।
लेकिन
जो चूक हुई,
मैं आपसे एक बात कहना चाहूंगा, क्योंकि आप एक बहुत, मैं आपको मानता हूं कि आप एक जिम्मेदार
अलाउ मी जस्ट अ सेकंड
सिंह साहब, आप जो बात आपने शुरुआत में भी, ये जब हमने अर्लियर इन द वीक भी शो किया था, आपने यही गलत फहमी इज्तिमा के बारे में कहा था। उस वक्त भी मैंने आपको कहा था कि बुलंदशहर का खुद पुलिस ट्वीट पे क्लैरिफाई कर रहा है कि इस घटना और इज्तिमा के बीच में कोई संबंध नहीं है, और उन्होंने रिक्वेस्ट किया कि लोग इस किस्म के गलत फहमियों को ना फैलाएं। इज्तिमा बिल्कुल पीसफुली खत्म होकर सब लोग डिस्पर्स हो गए। दूसरी बात, जो एडीजी हैं उनके रिपोर्ट में कहा गया है कि एक ये कंस्पिरेसी थी जिसमें ये योगेश राज वगैरह, बाकी बजरंग दल और ये सारे जो थे, उन एक साजिश रची कि इस वायलेंस को बढ़ाया जाए। पुलिस बार बार सही आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन दे रही है,
कैसे कोई
और आप
सरकार
अपने खुद
किसी
के पुलिस
को इजाजत दे सकती है
नहीं कर
कि आप कानून व्यवस्था हाथ में लीजिए। हम कह सकते हैं कि भारत माता की जय बोलने वालों में देशद्रोही भी हो सकते हैं, हमारे दुश्मन भी हो सकते हैं। इसका ये मतलब नहीं कि भारत माता की जय, भारत और वंदे मातरम कहने वाला सब सात्विक विचारधारा का है और उस लिहाज से वो इकट्ठा हुआ है। हमने एक बहुत साफ तौर से जो एसआईटी की रिपोर्ट आई उस आधार पर कह सकते हैं कि कानून व्यवस्था दुरुस्ती तेजमा को ठीक से जो संगम था 50 लाख मुसलमान उत्तर प्रदेश में इकट्ठा हुआ और वो अपने घर को गया, लेकिन जो साजिश हुई थी
बार बार जब पुलिस खुद कह रही है कोई कनेक्शन नहीं है, बार बार
हमारे कैसे दोहरा रहे
हैं। लेट मी अटेम्प्ट टू ब्रिंग इन अदर गेस्ट, विक्रम सिंह। सिंह साहब अगर आप परमिट करते हैं तो डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह से मैं पूछना चाहूंगा। डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह, दिस इज so disturbing that I am still not able to fully process this. You have a situation where a police officer has been murdered and we still don't know who has murdered him. The police has directed its entire attention. Now they're saying they're going to pursue the cow slaughter angle, not the fact that one of their own has been murdered. All sorts of rumors and political conspiracies theories are being spun. Have you ever seen anything like this in your career as a police officer?
Mr. Srinivasan Jain, let me tell you, I've eaten the salt of the police department for 36 years. And I would like to place on record 100 dacoities on one side and the murder of a policeman on one side. Whether it's USA, where he is known as a cop killer, or in India, it is known as Mazahimat. This is the worst crime, and every police officer is pursued, hound the criminals and the accused in this case. How can cow rights be precede? Or have a precedence over human rights. Human rights are sacrosanct and are sacred. Other rights can follow thereafter. But
you're saying, how can any issue, how can cow rights come over that, especially of a murdered police officer? Vrinda Grover, I'm trying to understand, how will the police now in Uttar Pradesh even attempt to prosecute this crime, the crime of the rioting of the murdered police officer, with the kind of intimidation they're facing? We just saw a video of the last remaining police officer who was involved in breaking up the mob has been transferred and the MLA is being fed laddus in celebration.
I think we are seeing a complete breakdown of constitutional machinery. The singular purpose of a state government is to protect the life and property of its citizens. It is not, and as the spokesperson here is again trying, to create disharmony and to create division between communities who are all belong to India. And that is actually a criminal offense. Even if it is done on a television channel, it will constitute a criminal offense. This state government is not going to permit the police. And the former police officer is absolutely right. If ever even a dacoit or gangster were to harm a police officer, it sends panic waves even within gangs, because they know that the wrath of the police will now fall upon them. What has happened here? A police officer in the course of his duty has been murdered by a mob that decided
yes.
There was an unlawful assembly with an intent. They have murdered him.
Yes.
And yet we are seeing
and
that there is no way in which the people who can be seen in the video, these videos are available, they can be identified, they are not being rounded up, they are not being arrested. What has happened within UP state? What is this breakdown? This is not a breakdown of law and order. It is a breakdown of the constitutional machinery.
Okay, let me just go across. Okay, Vrinda, let me just go across to Rahul Kaushik. Singh saab, main aa raha hu aapke paas. I'm coming back to you. Rahul Kaushik, you have a situation where those who are actually accused of this crime are making videos saying that the police officer was corrupt, the police officer is anti-Hindu. Not a single one of them have been arrested. Is it simply because of who they are, that they are the members of the Sangh Parivar? One of them is from the Bajrang Dal, is another from the BJP, another from the VHP. Is that why they have that kind of impunity, as we just heard Dr. Vikram Singh, former DG, say that normally if one police officer had been murdered, there would be absolute panic. But there is instead a complete sense of impunity, that we have the protection of the state because we are from the same ideological parivar?
I don't think so. I think most of the part that you have said is part of your perception about the Sangha parivar or them. No, there is no as such FIR still yet on them.
There is an FIR on them. They're all named in the FIR.
The administration has said that it was an accident. There's a mob which did that. So we need to look at that angle.
Let me speak now, Vasu. But you're not
freedom of expression. You are also speaking. No, everybody is speaking. Let me also get chance to speak.
But you just said that there's not an FIR against them. I wanted to correct you. There is an FIR against them.
Okay, I am sorry for that. There's an FIR. But the thing is that there is a Cow Protection Act in UP since 1955. Almost 50 cows were murdered there, whose bodies have been found there. That's a crime. We need to understand that that's a crime in that state.
If the chief minister
is saying that we need to investigate this, why were the villagers enraged? They were enraged because that thing happened.
Can I ask you a question? Is that crime, in your view, the figure of 50, by the way, is contested, but is that crime, in your view, a graver crime than the murder of a police officer?
See, nobody saw them killing the policeman. Even that is also contestable.
I'm not saying
everything is contestable. Even that is contestable.
No, you're saying the murder of the police officer. Are you saying that he was not murdered?
I haven't said that.
So I'm asking you, is it a graver crime? I haven't said
he has been murdered. We all know he has been murdered.
Is it a graver crime than the killing of the cows? It's just a yes or no.
Every killing is an equivalent crime.
It's the same thing.
Yes, it is.
The murder of a cow is the same as the murder of a police officer.
See, you need to understand the economy behind having a cow there.
I'm not asking you about economy.
You are killing a living when you are killing a cow.
Simple question, yes or no.
You guys do not live in villages, sir. That's why you do not understand what a cow is meant.
You don't live in a village either. You're sitting here talking to me in the Delhi studio. But that's not the point. You need to understand that
economy of a village is based on cow.
You answered my question. Can I just go across to Virendra Singh Sirohi? He's on the phone line with us, Bulandshahr MLA of the BJP. Virendra Singh ji, ye bataiye ki ek lag raha hai ki kanoon ka breakdown ho gaya hai Uttar Pradesh mein aur puri jo prashasan hai wo jin logon ne ye sara kiya hai, rioting kiya hai, ek police officer ke murder mein wo ek tarah se unka shayad role bhi ho sakta hai, unke zyada paksh mein hai. और जो पुलिस अफसर जिसकी हत्या हुई थी उनके बारे में क्या क्या फैलाया जा रहा है कि वो एंटी हिंदू थे, वो करप्ट थे, तो क्या कौन से साइड पे है उत्तर प्रदेश की सरकार?
देखिए, बुलंदशहर में किसाना थाने के अंदर एक जो घटना हुई है सिंगरौटी चौकी पर, ये घटना एक्सीडेंटल घटना है. गायों का मांस मिला लोगों को, वहां गौकसी हुई भाव के पास, वो वहां सब को लेकर रोड पर रख दिया. रोड जाम, तभी रोड जाम जब हुई एक बार पेड़ डाल दिया गया, तो रोड को खुलवाने का प्रयास, पुलिस आ गई मौके पर, और जो खुलवाने का प्रयास किया तो दोनों तरफ से हॉट टॉक हुई. तो धीरे धीरे जब आया कि क्योंकि मानते हम लोग हिंदू समाज,
घटना की पूरी इतिहास
के आधार पर लोगों का आना शुरू हुआ.
नहीं नहीं सिरोही साहब, घटना का पूरा इतिहास हमारे पास है. मेरा सवाल ये है कि अभी तक एक गिरफ्तारी नहीं हुई कि उस अफसर को किसने मारा.
ये तो मीडिया की देन हुई, एक तरह से मीडिया ट्रायल हो गया इसका. वहां पर कोई घटना ना तो हिंदू मुस्लिम का झगड़ा है, ये तो एक्सीडेंटल केस है. ना कोई लॉ एंड ऑर्डर का मसला है, ना कोई सरकार की सेलो का मसला है, ना कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन का वो है.
एक्सीडेंटल
चीज है, ज्यादा है. इसको मीडिया ट्रायल हो गया क्योंकि वहां पर
अच्छा मीडिया ट्रायल हो गया. ओके,
ये दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना है. पुलिस अधिकारी वो भी अपने आदमी है, दूसरे मरे वो भी अपने आदमी है. इस प्रकार की घटना ये दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण
घटना है. यू आर ऑलमोस्ट सेइंग, जैसे सीएम कह रहे हैं दैट दिस इज अ सॉर्ट ऑफ एन एक्सीडेंट. कैन आई जस्ट हैव डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह बैक? डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह
जी,
कैन यू हियर मी?
वीरेन सिरोही जी कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर रहे, उन्होंने बहुत साफ तौर से कहा, जो वही से बिलोंग करते हैं, उन्होंने कहा एक दुर्घटना है. ये दुर्घटना उसी तरह जैसे 1994 में एक डीएम को गोपालगंज के डीएम को
अच्छा आप 1994 में पहुंच गए कैन आई जस्ट गो क्रॉस टू डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह उनको तो बात करने का मौका ही नहीं मिला डॉक्टर विक्रम सिंह यू वर सेइंग
एसपी को
व्हेन वी लॉस्ट यू
दिया गया था ये दुर्घटना
सिंह साहब जस्ट अ सेकंड आईपी सिंह साहब बोलिए
मिस्टर जैन मे आई सबमिट प्लीज ये दुर्घटना नहीं है ये कोल्ड ब्लडेड डिलीबरेट मर्डर है
सर प्लीज
और अपराधियों की गिरफ्तारी के समग्र और सार्थक प्रयास नहीं किए गए हैं आरोपियों के ऊपर पुरस्कार की घोषणा क्यों नहीं की गई आरोपी और इसके अलावा आपने एक मृतक आरोपी को 10 लाख रुपए का मुआवजा दिया गया मुआवजा दिया जाता है शहीदों को अपराधियों को मुआवजा देने का कोई प्राविधान नहीं है और इसके अलावा इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्वेलेंस के माध्यम से
थ्रू इलेक्ट्रॉनिक
क्रिमिनल्स आई वुड लाइक टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट एफर्ट्स हैव बीन मेड बाय यू टू गेट टू द क्रिमिनल्स यू हैव नॉट अनाउंस्ड कैश रिवॉर्ड्स ऑन देयर अरेस्ट You have not made dedicated teams to ensure that they are behind bars. And here they are challenging your authority by going publicly through videos uploaded them. Okay. Is it rocket science to get to them when they are disclosing their identity by uploading their videos?
Okay.
I really don't see whether you are serious about their arrest or
okay,
not.
Okay, all right. I have literally 30 seconds left. A quick question to you, Rahul Kaushik. Yeah. There is a demand that is now coming up that what has happened in Bulandshahr is an act of terrorism and there should be a ban now on groups like the Bajrang Dal. Would you support that?
Not at all. It was an accident. I will repeat that. The murder of a policeman is condemnable.
But it's an condemned accident.
But it happened in an accident. It was a mob which did that. Mob ka koi face nahi hota hai. We need to investigate it. We need to get facts. And
so
then we need to punish the person.
Murdered in Kashmir, that's an accident as well.
Are you comparing Kashmir with Bulandshahr? Are you comparing? Are you fine with that comparison?
I'm talking about.
Are you fine with that comparison? If Kashmir is comparable with Bulandshahr, are you fine with that?
So what's the difference? Tell me. What's the difference between the murder of a police
officer?
There is
a clear case of terrorism happening there. There is a counter-insurgency happening there from Pakistan. It cannot be compared from. Are you comparing local villagers of Uttar Pradesh with terrorists from Kashmir?
Ministers in the Uttar Pradesh government are. They're saying the Bajrang Dal should be banned. Quickly, Vrinda Grover, 30 seconds. Is there a case now to look at these groups with a view towards a ban?
I think we should, right now, be focusing more on documenting what they have been repeatedly doing. They are creating disharmony. They are inciting mobs. They are making sure that those who are entrusted with maintaining law and order cannot perform their work. And I think it's a wake-up call to the UP police. The mob has been unleashed. It will not stop only at lynching the Muslim. It will lynch the policeman.
Okay.
It will lynch every citizen. And this is a crime, a heinous crime. By calling it an accident, we are taking away the intention behind it. It is not an accident. It is a heinous crime.
Okay. All right. We're out of time. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. That's it on Truth vs. Hype. That's all the time we have. Thanks for watching. Good night.